Okay, so this is the new 3D printer room we're building. We made some progress. I mean, we still got ways to go, but we have to design a door. We're thinking about like one of those like rolling barn doors that rolls with the enclosures.
And I have to put a bigger cross beam.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we're definitely not finished, obviously.
Yeah,
because this the way it is, it's gonna shake. So we'll have to support that. We kind of ran out of the boards that were long enough.
Cause that's like over a 2 foot stretch right there.
Did you have one of the 2x6s that was long enough?
Yeah. But this is what it looks like back here. I mean, we still got to put exterior on here. I mean, this is just start. We still got a lot more work to do.
Are you going to put any designs on that wall? Or are you just going to put it just one color? Are you going to not really treat it with anything?
The same panel
or paint
the rest of the house over.
Those kind of panels.
Basically exterior paneling.
So it'll look congruent with the other side.
We're going to paint it too. We're going to paint that side when we're through.
Oh, yeah.
And then we got to cover up like this opening right here.
Fill in the gap.
Yeah. I guess the next step, like this week, is to start insulating it. I mean, right now, just for temporarily, we have this stuff up. We're gonna put on the ceiling, but like Santi was saying, we need to actually do it properly, cut it up in strips, and actually put like a real ceiling up.
I mean, it's the layers that helps with the insulation.
Yeah. This table, I mean, right now this is where we're keeping all the steel. It goes in the lathe and the mill. But this, we're actually going to build a steel rack right here. So the idea is we're going to use these 4x4s and dig holes, put concrete in there, and level it up, square it up. And we're going to have like a rack, like a table. So all of our steel will go out here instead of inside the 3D printer room. And then we're going to put like a big industrial saw right here. So basically, you'll roll the saw out, bring the material up, saw it up, and then bring it to the shop, right? But
we need to get the rest of the walls and everything on there so we can go in and seal up everything and insulate everything so we can actually put that AC unit in there.
Good. So the next steps is to actually get that table out of there, cut a hole in the wall for a window unit so we get AC. Definitely gonna need AC. But I mean, that kind of goes at the same time as, you know, if we put a window unit in here, we also gotta have a door and at least some kind of insulation. So all of this will get moved out. And then what you're gonna see is we're gonna have like 8 tables like this. So this table is perfect for a 3D printer, for the WorkHorse printer. So we'll be able to build 5 printers at the same time. And what I want to do is put these on wheels. So basically, there'll be different stages, you know, like we can keep all the extrusions and parts underneath here. So you pull all the parts out, build the frame, right? The frame's built, then you roll it over and it gets put, it goes to the next section. So it's gonna be like an assembly line. So you build the frame on one table, roll it over. The next person puts all of the gantry parts and the lead screw and the carriage parts and all that. Then it rolls over to the next section. Somebody will finish all the whatever's rest, the enclosure, the wiring. They'll roll over to the next section and they actually wire it up to the electronics board. Start getting it moving. Then it'll be a testing station. But this table doesn't take up too much space. Like, we should easily be able to fit 8 of these. So imagine this. But we'll have one like right here, one right here, right here, right here. Then we'll have one right here, here, there, there. So we should be able to fit 8 of them. And we'll probably just put a window unit. I think the window unit would be a good, like this would be a good spot right here. What do you think, Santi?
I don't know, I thought about The only other thing I had thought about putting it, I mean, you said right here, if we're putting it right here, it ought to be up against something sturdy can mount stuff in. But I also had the thought the other day, if we put it up high, like in a corner somewhere, higher up off the ground, like if you put it right here, it's kind of going to take away from this area being a little workspace.
Yeah.
Because either you can't put that much stuff on the wall right there, or you're going to have the AC blowing directly in your face while you're trying to work right here at this table. Whereas if you had it up high, you'd save some wall space, I feel like. Maybe.
Yeah, true. We actually, we could put it up higher, like here.
Yeah.
I was thinking, if we put it on that wall, because the AC is blowing this way, when someone opens the door, the AC is just going to blow right out the shop.
Well, I mean, the same could be said for if you put the AC on this end, because it's closer to the door, it'll just suck it right out, too.
Sure,
I don't know.
Sure.
Either way, you're going to have to keep it closed.
Either way, we're going to have to keep it close to keep the AC in there, regardless.
But, I mean, it is a start. We still got to remove our awesome droopy fan.
Custom vintage fan?
Yeah, custom vintage fan. If anybody wants to buy a custom vintage fan, this is a one-of-a-kind fan.
Like 1970 right here. I can't promise it works, but but hey, maybe it's a fixer upper, you know? Somebody might want to buy it. We'll let it go for $20. Smell some beer. I don't know if you can smell beer.
Why couldn't you go beer?
I don't know.
A lot of water weight.
Well, if it gets dropped.
Yeah,
it only gets too hot too, but I mean.
Unless it's really close, the shipping wouldn't be worth it.
Yeah.
Yeah, true. I mean, so we still got a lot of work. I was kind of thinking about doing...
How do you think the beer gets to the gas station in the first place anyway?
Yeah, a lot of the town shipping.
Truck.
Up here?
Oh, yeah.
But going all the way around? That'd be kind of cool.
Hey, you can hang stuff up.
I kind of feel like we need a dry erasing board too.
I was about to say, I think you do like two walls and pegboard and do like that wall and dry erase.
Yeah. We definitely need a dry erasing board. Because we're always like, oh, we need to do this. No,
I think we need one both places. One for the printer shop and one for the machine shop.
Yeah.
I was gonna say like put all the dry erase boards there for everything, but. It might be a better idea to keep the workstations for the two different
things. Dude, I was at Home Depot. They actually have a dry erase board, 4x8 at Home Depot.
Don't they have the spray?
They got the spray too.
I mean, we could use the chalkboard spray for the same thing.
Somebody tells me the spray wouldn't work as good. I mean, I'm underwhelmed.
I'm on with you on that same thought, but
I know the
spray chalkboard works fairly well.
That's not too bad, man. Imagine like a 4x8 dry erase board.
It'd be way cheaper for sure to make our own with the paint than it would be trying to...
They make this 4 foot by 8 foot too, so we don't really need that. I mean, I think a dry erase board maybe towards like the middle, or you know, where are we going to use it at? Probably like, well, I mean, there's a window unit here, so you don't want to put it there.
I think right there would be best.
But yeah,
I mean, that just comes down to where, how we organize everything. That could change
real quick.
I mean, are we going to build a big printer right there, or are we going to build a big printer right there, or are we going to have which side of the station is going to be on that's going to make it the easiest to roll stuff around? We need to roll stuff around. That's also assuming that we go do ahead and lay something over the floor.
Definitely
and
that
put the linoleum over the floor, because otherwise there's not much sense in trying to put rolly carts out here with the floor the way it is.
That's another thing, we got to put a floor down here.
Before we can do the floor, we got to finish the walls and insulate and seal everything and figure out what we're doing about that hole along the back track over there. It might be easier to do some of the floor before we do that, and it might be much better to do that first, depending. Because if we do that first, I mean, if we do the floor first, we could just have the whatever we put go out to that and cut it to shape, or we could put something there before we cut everything to shape for the top of the floor. We'll have to think on that and figure out that plan before we start buying shit and drawing it together.
So,
but once that's done, I mean, we need to go through and seal everything and make sure that everything is insulated good before we can put the rest of the walls up.
Yeah.
And then we can put the rest of the walls and the ceiling and all that insulation.
I'm wondering why this was on top of here all weird like.
See, the good thing about these tables is, like, we have workstations, right? So, like, one is putting the frame together. Another workstation would actually be assembling the gantry and carriage. But for each workstation, they all had their own tools and supplies. Like the frame, for example, all the extrusions, the proper tools to square it up, you know, you got a square, maybe some kind of clamps or something. All of that can be underneath here. And we can just roll them around. It'd be perfect.
Probably make sure you're gonna
weld some wheels down in
here. Yeah. I was thinking we could also do is get some like 2x4s and cut it to length and we can screw it in and lock it down there and screw the wheels in from the
If you wanted a cart for the extrusions, we could make a cart, but I think upright would be best.
Yeah, I like that. I was thinking about that yesterday.
If you just have a cart with slots for it, you can set all the bundles of extrusions for each size in their own section.
Also, we're gonna have a bunch of new people here too, so we want like directions like on the wall. Like, so each station, say this is the frame station, right? Okay, so we gotta think, when we bring materials in here, like the flow of our workspace. So we'll probably have a table here on wheels, that'll be right here, right? So you know, we'll probably have like some new guys. What we can do is put like the instructions on the wall. You know what I mean? Like the blueprints, how many parts, the build materials, what leaves, what order of operations to assemble in it.
You know, I have a feeling this is eventually going to be your office.
Yeah, eventually. Well, eventually the garage is going to be the 3D printer area, and we'll just build a freaking steel building back there.
I'm still hoping it's a concrete building.
Concrete?
Yeah.
Bunker.
I mean, this is temporary right now. So,
Delta printer?
So right now we only build one printer at a time. So, I mean, it's a big printer and it's pretty heavy duty, but we need to get any kind of efficiency. We need to build at least 5 at a time. Eventually, bump it up to like 10. But I mean, right now we've only been selling kits. So we've been in the kit business and I think we're getting close to actually get into the 3D printer business. We're selling the complete printers working. We are looking for beta testers, right? But you know, one thing we got to worry about is cash flow. Actually keeping all the parts in the inventory. That's pretty big because our printers are, you know, our printers are pretty big. They have a lot of expensive parts on it. Cause we use the good stuff. We use I just lead screw. We use Duet Wi-Fi. We're using the Misumi extrusions. We're using the good Acme lead screw. Like all the parts, you know, it's all good parts. So it gets pretty expensive. So that's one reason why we haven't actually started selling complete printers yet. We're just selling kits. Keeping all that stuff in the inventory. Another thing is logistics. Actually shipping printers. And say we ship a printer to Ohio, right? Is it gonna work when we get to Ohio? How much tech support are we gonna have to offer, you know? So that's another thing. We already have enough support we gotta deal with right now just selling kits. I mean, that's already kind of a challenge on its own. But, so this is a start, you know? I mean, this is just to get things going, you know, and build 5 printers at a time. That's pretty good for us. We're still a startup. Eventually we want to build 10 at a time, if not more.
Definitely be way easier to crank out a bunch of the smaller ones, parts-wise.
Yeah. Well, another thing, we need more space too, because we also have we have the new WorkHorse XL we're building, right? That is twice as big as the WorkHorse. Like this is actually an old WorkHorse frame. That's from like the first prototype. That's small. That's quite a bit smaller. That had a 250mm by 550mm build area. The new ones have 650 by 350. Right. Well, the new printer, the WorkHorse XL, has a 600 by 600 by 600 area. So it's pretty huge. I mean, it's going to take up about this much space. You know, I mean, it's a big printer. So I mean, we probably only have 4 of those going on in here at one time. And then we also have a bigger printer that we want to start working on. That's why the doorway, if you notice, the doorway is pretty big here. So if you look at this, we're actually designing the doorway where it can be modified. Like, so we plan on building like a really big printer. Like, I mean, our long-term goal is to be 3D printing houses like 5 years from now. So what I'm getting at is, we're designing this opening where we build a printer that say, you know, 10 foot by 10 foot by 10 foot, that we can actually get out of here. So that's one thing we're looking at. But you gotta think, a 10 foot printer,
it's better, probably.
So we got 8 foot here.
Actually, we wouldn't be able to do go 10 foot. Well, I mean, we're literally, one of the machines we're looking at, we're designing right now, it's going to be from about here to here, about from here to here. I guess we'll have to change the height so we actually fit it into the first area.
So you could 3D print like a... like a mannequin, a human mannequin.
Yeah, easily.
With a fancy top hat.
We want to be able to print like tables and chairs and couches and stuff like that.
You could maybe 3D print like Alice in Wonderland having tea on a table with a crazy cat. And
print Alice in Wonderland.
Well, like the tea party.
The
crazy rabbit.
Yeah.
That would be fun.
But I mean, another issue with the bigger printers is what materials we're gonna use, because you can only get so big with just plastic. I mean, unless you have like a super awesome extruder. But yeah, so this is the next step. Hopefully we'll be moving in here a week from now.
I think my favorite part is still the tire marks on the wall.
I like that when you bought it.
So is that it?
Yeah, that's it.